ओके, स्क्रीन शेयर हो गया?
यस सर।
यस सर।
यस सर।
ओके ओके ओके, गुड। सो फ्रॉम द लास्ट टू लेक्चर्स वी स्टार्टेड द ड्रग एंड मैजिक रेमेडीज एक्ट 1954 एंड द रूल्स 1955। द ड्रग एंड मैजिक रेमेडीज एक्ट आल्सो कॉल्ड एज ऑब्जेक्शनेबल एडवर्टाइजमेंट एक्ट। ओके, सो ऑब्जेक्शनेबल एडवर्टाइजमेंट एक्ट दो दिन दो लेक्चर से हम लोग पढ़ रहे हैं, शॉर्ट रिविजन वापिस से हम लोग कर लेते हैं। Okay, so whatever the fake advertisement are there, whatever the misleading advertisement are there, for fake advertisement, misleading advertisement, magic advertisements. Okay, so against to that act, to control and regulate such advertisement, the act is get passed. Okay, with the main objectives that. Okay, so though we are just going to study the main objective later on. We'll study the various examples of the your misleading advertisement, that misleading advertisements ke do teen example hum logon ne already padhe hai. I'm not going to dictate once again. Okay, so promise to cure the horrible diseases like the cancer and AIDS, that are the your misleading advertisement. A medical practitioner advertisement to his clinic claiming that offer definite cure of epilepsy, and by that time IMA, Indian Medical Association, in this case declare him a fraud based on finding the committee that he was giving his patient the lethal dose at the high doses. India is the land of spiritualities and the Babas very well known. There has not been a law specifically to prosecute those making false spiritual claim and the deceive people. For them, we say that the act is useful. Okay, so the main objective of this act is nothing but else to control the advertisement of drugs in certain cases, to prohibit the advertisement of certain purposes of remedies alleged to possess magic qualities. Okay, so to control the advertisement of the drugs, to prohibit the advertisement related to the magic remedies. Okay, so these two are the main objectives for this act. दो मार्क्स के लिए क्वेश्चन नंबर वन में पूछा जाता है क्वेश्चन, व्हाट आर द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ ड्रग एंड मैजिक रेमेडीज एक्ट 1954 एंड द रूल्स 1955. यू हैव टू राइट दिस टू ऑब्जेक्टिव, देन यू आर एलिजिबल टू गेट योर फुल टू मार्क्स. ओके, द एक्ट इज एक्सटेंडेड टू होल इंडिया एक्सेप्ट स्टेट ऑफ जम्मू एंड कश्मीर. वी आर अंडर द एजुकेशन रेगुलेशन 1991, दैट्स व्हाई जो पुराना जो सिलेबस के हिसाब से हम लोगों को पढ़ाना पड़ रहा है. बट यू कीप इन माइंड कि ये एक्ट आज के डेट में जम्मू एंड कश्मीर में भी एक्सटेंड हो चुका होगा. ओके, देन इट शैल बी कम इन फोर्स इन सच अ डेट एज अ सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट मे बाय नोटिफिकेशन इन द ऑफिशियल गैजेट व्हिच मे अपॉइंट. सो ऑफिशियल गैजेट्स आर नथिंग बट एल्स व्हाटएवर द डॉक्यूमेंट साइन बाय द ऑथराइज्ड पर्सन ऑफ द government, central government of India, state governments of the various state governments of the India that are called as your official gazette. Definition of the advertisement already we have studied, includes any notice, circular, label, wrapper or other document and any announcement made orally or by any means of producing or transmitting the light, sound or the smoke. It's a advertisement's definition. Definition of the drug already we studied under the chapter Drug and Cosmetic Act 1940 and the rules 1945. Then definition of the magic remedies includes talisman, mantra, kavach and any other charm of any kind which is alleged to possess miraculous power for or in the diagnosis, cure, mitigation, treatment or prevention of any disease in human being or animal for affecting or influencing any way the structure or any organic function of the body of human being or the animal. So it's definition of the advertisement, definition of the magic remedy. They might be asked into your examination for 2 marks. You have to write the whole definition. Then registered medical practitioner, the definition already we cover under the heading Pharmacy Act 1948 and the Drug and Cosmetic Act 1940 and the rules 1945. The same definitions you have to write if they ask the question, define registered medical practitioner as under Drug and Magic Remedies Act. Tino Act mein, same definition hai, same likhna hai, confuse karne ke liye students ko aise question puche jane ke chances rehte hai final examination mein. Classes of prohibited advertisement. So class 1 we studied already, then we also studied the class 2, class 3 that we studied in the last lecture. I am not going to dictate once again. Then class 4, prohibition of misleading advertisement relating to drug, that we already covered. Class 4 and the class 6 is there. Okay, keep in mind, prohibited advertisement ke baare mein examination mein pucha gaya. What are the prohibited advertisement? What are the various classes of prohibited advertisement as under the Drug and Cosmetic, as under the Drug and Magic Remedies Act? You have to write in your own language, no problem. Okay, aapke khud ke language mein aap likhoge to bhi chal jayega. Nobody will be there to deduct your marks. But jo point hai, class 6 tak jo point hai, wo sab ke sab wahan pe aapke language mein bhi likhoge aap to bhi chalega, cover ho jane chahiye. Okay, so these are the various. These are the various prohibited advertisement, okay, that we already cover in your last lecture. So in today's lecture, we are going to cover various classes of exempted advertisement. Exempted. माने ये exempted माने क्या? ये act में से permitted advertisement जो है, वो आज हम लोग पढ़ेंगे, okay? जो ये एक्ट के तहत एडवर्टाइजमेंट करने के लिए इलिजिबल है, वेरियस वे ऑफ एडवर्टाइजमेंट, कौन कौन से प्रोडक्ट के आप एडवर्टाइजमेंट कर सकते हो, ये वो वर्ड का मीनिंग आ जाएगा एग्जेम्प्टेड करके, कल क्यूमुलेटिवली करके हम लोग बोलेंगे एग्जेम्प्टेड. ओके, क्लासेस ऑफ परमिटेड एडवर्टाइजमेंट, क्लासेस ऑफ एग्जेम्प्टेड एडवर्टाइजमेंट, वन एंड द सेम. ओके, एनी एडवर्टाइजमेंट, द फर्स्ट क्लास इज देयर. Any advertisement relating to the drug printed or published by the government or any other person with prior permission of the government. Okay, permission liya hua hai government ke paas se. Okay, printed form mein hai. Okay, ya drug printed or published by the government. Any advertisement relating to the drugs printed or published by government or any other person with prior permission of the government. Okay, so government ya government ke permission se kuch advertisement jo hai aap display kar sakte ho, uska aise product ka advertisement kar sakte hai. Any advertisement relating to the drug which is sent confidentially in the prescribed manner to the registered medical practitioner. Okay, so any advertisement, we can say that any advertisement relating to a drug which is sent confidentially in the prescribed manner, okay, in the prescribed manner to registered medical practitioner, so wo advertisement exempted advertisement aa jayega. 3 marks ke liye question puch sakte hai, 4 marks ke liye question pucha ja sakta hai MSBT mein aapko. What are the various classes of exempted advertisement as under the Drug and Magic Remedies Act 1945 and the rules 1955. Class 3, advertisement including any book or treatise or written or printed composition dealing with any matter relating to the disease, disorder or condition which are otherwise prohibited, provided, published from bona fide scientific or social point of view. Once again, I am repeating, any advertisement, including any book or the treatise dealing with any matter relating to the disease, disorder, condition, which are otherwise prohibited, provided, published from bona fide scientist or social point of view. Okay, so aisa advertisement aap kar sakte ho as per the Drug and Magic Remedies Act. Next. Class 4. Displayed signboard or notices by registered medical practitioner on his premises indicating that the treatment is undertaken for any disease, disorder or condition specified in the schedule to this act or in the rules made under this act. Displayed signboard or notices in the registered medical practitioner on his premises, uska RMP, registered medical practitioner ya physician ke clinic mein, dispensary mein ya hospital mein, okay, ye premises mein kuch signboard display kiya hai, kuch notice display kiya hai, wo indicate kar raha hai ki treatment is undertaken for any diseases, disorder or condition specified in the schedule to this act or in the rule made under this act. Okay, so this one is the your class 4. Class 5th of exempted advertisement as per the Drug and Magic Remedies Act 1954 and the rules 1955, advertisement relating to the drugs which comply with the required condition as follow: subclass 1, leaflet or literature along with packaging of the drugs or advertisement of drugs in medicinal, pharmaceutical, scientific or technical journal. I am once again repeating the class 5th, subclass 1, leaflet or literature along with packaging of the drugs or advertisement of drugs in the medicinal, pharmaceutical, scientific and technical journals. Okay, so leaflet and literature along with packaging of the drugs. Okay, बहुत बार हम लोगों ने देखा होगा कि भाई कुछ सिरप लेके आ जाते हैं तो आउटर जो कवर रहेगा, बॉक्स रहेगा, तो उसमें जो रहेगा कुछ लिफलेट या लिटरेचर रहता है ड्रग्स के बारे में. ओके, सो तो वो ऐसा एडवर्टाइजमेंट, इट इज एग्जेम्प्टेड एडवर्टाइजमेंट एज पर द ड्रग एंड मैजिक रेमेडीज एक्ट 1954 एंड द रूल्स 1955. Class subclass 2 of class 5th, therapeutic index or price list published by licensed manufacturer, importer or distributor of drugs under the Drug and Cosmetic Act 1940 and the rules thereunder, or medical literature distributed by medical representatives. Okay, bahut baar hum logon ne suna hoga, common language mein MR bola jata hai, that are called as medical representative. So aisa literature medical representative ke paas se agar ko distribute ho jata hai, that is called as your exempted advertisement. Ya fir therapeutic index or price list published by licensed manufacturer, importer or distributor of the drugs, okay, like your drug index, okay, drug today, aisa therapeutic index rehta hai, price list rehta hai, to usme kuch advertisement rehta hai, वो एडवर्टाइजमेंट हम लोग बोल सकते हैं एग्जम्प्टेड एडवर्टाइजमेंट में आ जाता है. क्लास 6, एनी एडवर्टाइजमेंट रिलेटिंग टू अ ड्रग प्रिंटेड और पब्लिश विद प्रीवियस सैंक्शन ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट ग्रांटेड प्रायर टू द कमेंसमेंट ऑफ द ड्रग एंड मैजिक रेमेडीज एक्ट, दैट इज योर ऑब्जेक्शनेबल एडवर्टाइजमेंट एक्ट 1963, दैट इज योर amendment was made into the your Drug and Magic Remedies Act 1954. Usme ek amendment kiya gaya tha 1963 mein ki bhai uske pehle 1963 ke pehle kuch advertisement rahega, kuch sanction diya hai government mein, to okay, to such a advertisement jo printed hai aur publish kiya hai सैंक्शन लेके गवर्नमेंट से, ओके, तो वैसे एडवर्टाइजमेंट एग्जेम्प्टेड एडवर्टाइजमेंट में आ जाते हैं. ओके, सो दिस मच अबाउट द योर एग्जेम्प्टेड एडवर्टाइजमेंट. 6 क्लासेस है आपके एग्जेम्प्टेड एडवर्टाइजमेंट के. अगेन यू कैन राइट इन एग्जामिनेशन इन योर ओन लैंग्वेज, नो प्रॉब्लम फॉर द सेम. ओके, बट कीप इन माइंड पूरे के पूरे पॉइंट वहां पे जो है वो कवर हो जाने चाहिए. वी कम एट द योर सेकंड लास्ट पॉइंट ऑफ द योर लेक्चर और द सॉरी दिस चैप्टर एज द ऑफेंसेस एंड पेनल्टीज एज अंडर द ड्रग एंड मैजिक रेमेडीज एक्ट. कॉन्ट्रावेंशन ऑफ एनी ऑफ द प्रोविजन ऑफ दिस एक्ट और द रूल्स देयर अंडर. कॉन्ट्रावेंशन जो प्रोविजन है, एग्जेम्प्टेड एडवर्टाइजमेंट का प्रोविजन है, प्रोहिबिटेड एडवर्टाइजमेंट का कुछ प्रोविजन है, तो ये प्रोविजन के कॉन्ट्रावेंशन में कुछ ऑफेंस हो जाता है. ओके, देन द पर्सन इज पनिशेबल विथ इम्प्रिजनमेंट अप टू 6 months और फाइन और विथ बोथ ऑन द फर्स्ट कन्विक्शन. ओके, पहला ऑफेंस, पहला अटेम्प्ट में हम लोग बोल सकते हैं कोई पर्सन से हो जाता है, देन वी से दैट पर्सन वी आर पनिशेबल फॉर द 6 months इम्प्रिजनमेंट विथ फाइन और द बोथ. देन बी पनिशेबल विथ इम्प्रिजनमेंट अप टू 1 year, दैट इज द 12 months, और विथ फाइन और बोथ ऑन द सब्सिक्वेंट कन्विक्शन. पहला अटेम्प्ट, पहले कन्विक्शन के बाद वाला सब्सिक्वेंट कन्विक्शन. ओके, दूसरा तीसरा चौथा हम लोग बोल सकते हैं, तो 1 साल का इम्प्रिजनमेंट हो सकता है और फाइन भी हो सकता है, या फिर बोथ. पनिशमेंट इज इलिजिबल और द गिवन टू सच अ पर्सन इफ ही और शी डू एनी कॉन्ट्रावेंशन फॉर ऑफ एनी ऑफ द प्रोविजन ऑफ ड्रग एंड मैजिक रेमेडीज एक्ट एंड द रूल्स देयर अंडर. सेकंड वी से ऑफेंसेस एंड पेनल्टीज इन केस ऑफ कॉन्ट्रावेंशन ऑफ द प्रोविजन ऑफ द एक्ट बाय कंपनी or any industry or any pharmaceutical industry or any premises related to the drug and magic remedies. Every person who at the time of the commission of the offense was in charge and responsible for the conduct of the company business shall be deemed to guilty and liable for the punishment. Okay, each person, every person at the time of the offense was in charge. Okay, offense के समय पे जो person है, जितने भी person है, okay, वो in charge है and responsible for the conduct of the company business shall deem to be guilty. Okay, उनको consider किया जाता है, guilty consider किया जाता है and liable for the punishment. तो punishment कैसा है? However, such a person is not liable for the punishment if he proves that offense was committed without his knowledge or that he is taken all precaution to prevent the commission of such a offense. Okay, so punishment se pehle hum log bol sakte hain ki agar aisa person hai ki uske wo bolega ki bhai jo offense hua hai, to offense committed hua hai without his knowledge, is uske knowledge ke bagair hua hai, wo prove karwa deta hai, to wo prevent ho jata hai aise offense mein se. Okay, and the punishment is the same. We say that on the first conviction, there is a 6 months imprisonment is there and the fine or the both on the first conviction. If the second conviction is there or subsequent conviction rahega, to wo jo punishment hai wo double ho jayega. That is the 1 year or the 12 months imprisonment or fine or both is as a punishment for the same. Okay, the schedule. Schedule to the Drug and Magic Remedies Act 1954 and the rules there under 1955. उसके लिए एक ही शेड्यूल है, name of the disease or disorder or conditions. Okay, so name of the disease, disorder or the condition. Okay, prohibited advertisement में मैंने बताया था. Okay, so whatever the schedule, disease, disorder or the your डिसीज डिसऑर्डर रहेगा, शेड्यूल डिसीज रहेगा, शेड्यूल डिसऑर्डर रहेगा या फिर कंडीशन रहेगा, तो वो क्योर होता है, ऐसा एडवर्टाइजमेंट प्रोहिबिटेड है. बाय द टाइम आई टोल्ड यू दैट इन द लास्ट लेक्चर कि भाई हम लोग एट द एंड ऑफ दिस योर लेक्चर और द एंड ऑफ दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू कवर द वन शेड्यूल इज देयर. द शेड्यूल इज एज अंडर द ड्रग एंड मैजिक रेमेडीज एक्ट, दैट इज योर नेम ऑफ द डिसीज एंड डिसऑर्डर और कंडीशन. So, ये enlisted 54 diseases, 54 disorder या फिर condition दिख रहे हैं, that is comes under your drug and magic remedies act schedules. Okay, what are the various DC disorder or conditions are there? We say that is the blindness, blood poisoning, then your bright disease, cancer, cataracts, epilepsy, dropsy, fits. We say that female diseases, all the female diseases in general comes under your schedule of the drug and magic remedies act. Then your sexual impotence, smallpox, tuberculosis, typhoid fever. Then we say that ulcers of the gastrointestinal tract, venereal diseases including syphilis, gonorrhea. Then your we say the plagues, paralysis. Okay, so these are the various diseases, disorder and the conditions are there in the schedule of drug and magic remedies act. Okay, so these are the references from where the presentation was prepared. Okay, so thank you. कुछ डिफिकल्टी है तो पूछो.